Please, you have the floor for 4 minutes. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Dear Commissioner Breton, can I say at the outset how pleased I am to take the floor in this important debate and to welcome you on behalf of the EPP group to thank you for your important and indeed reassuring intervention. Unfortunately, I cannot be in Brussels in person. Instead, I speak to you from one of Europe's most beautiful regions, the southeast of Ireland. Commissioner, on the back of a pandemic that has shaken Europe and our everyday way of living, containment measures are now gradually being eased as we, I suppose, transition from a crisis management phase to a recovery phase. For me, this means passing the baton, I suppose, to a new set of frontline heroes in the form of our SMEs, many of which are family-owned businesses, all of which invest, hire, and spend local. In practice, too, this also means, firstly, getting otherwise healthy SMEs up and running again through viable alternatives like equity finance and venture capital instead of more debt-based, unsustainable loans. Secondly, tackling the barriers to our precious single market with a view to finally see it reach its full potential and addressing the distortive effects of foreign subsidies. The EPP welcomes the white paper in this regard and now looks forward to it being given teeth and leading to the legislative proposals. My own opinion, Commissioner, adopted yesterday on the implementation of free trade agreements emphasizes the importance of take-up from SMEs and, crucially, the knowledge gap that they are often faced. Commissioner, the EPP Group supports an ambitious and future-orientated recovery plan for Europe, and I echo my colleagues who stress our willingness, the COR's willingness, to be an institutional partner in the discussions on their component proposals. The European Recovery Instrument and Next Generation EU, with its long-term budget, are unprecedented, but nonetheless a necessary response to the COVID-19 pandemic. They complement the three important safety nets agreed by leaders in April, and they complement earlier measures like the SURE programme, the finance available from the European Investment Bank and the European Stability Mechanism. We particularly welcome the solvency support instrument that will provide a union guarantee to the EIP group in order to mobilise private capital to support eligible companies negatively impacted by the COVID-19 crisis. Not least, due to the given context of COVID-19 compounded by Brexit on the horizon, we need to see a swift solution on the package, including the volume and the balance between grant and loans. Commissioner, investment in rebuilding comes at a high price, that of rising unsustainable debt. We must take care of both targets. Fiscal consolidation must be the foundation on which we build sustainable growth. Commissioner, major issues that form part of your portfolio include, like, the untapped potential of Europe's digital horizon and the shaping of artificial intelligence in line with European values, strengthening our cybersecurity, forging a more circular industrial model, and finally making our intellectual property regime fit for the modern age. These challenges have not gone away. Instead, they have never been more important for Europe's competitiveness. Commissioner, I thank you for your attention and I look forward to the ensuing exchanges. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you.